Good morning, students. I welcome you all to the SimStar Online Learning. This is Muskan Parwar, and I am back with another topic related to Chapter 3, Addition and Subtraction within 20. Students, if you remember, in our previous video, we have learned about addition. Yes, addition of one-digit numbers, addition of three one-digit numbers, yes, and number line. So, students, today we will learn about subtraction. Okay, before beginning with subtraction, first of all, let me tell you what is subtraction. What do you mean by subtraction? Subtraction simply means taking away one number from another. That is subtraction. Okay, let's take some example. If I have 5 toffees, or if I give you 5 toffees, okay. These are 5 toffees, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, if I gave you 5 toffees and I told you to give 2 toffees to your friend. Okay, I said give 2 toffees to your friend. Then how many toffees are left with you? So what you will do? You will subtract. You are taking away few toffees from the given toffee. Yes, so if I told you to take 2 toffees away, means 1, 2. You have given these 2 toffees to your friend. Now let's see how many toffees are left. So what we will do? We will cut first 2 toffees. Let's see how many are left. 1, 2, 3. 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. Okay, 3 toffees are left. Understood? Subtraction means taking away from one number to another. Okay, now let's learn how to arrange numbers while doing subtraction. Let's see. If I give you a number 15 minus 5 is equal to dash, and I told you please arrange these numbers under the column of ones and tens, so how we will do? We will write tens once, then we will write 15, where 5 will be placed at the ones place and 1 will be placed at the tens place. Now let's come to number 5. 5 has only one digit, so we will write 5 and then we will subtract. Now 5 minus 5, we have to subtract 5 minus 5. So what we will do? We will draw lines and learn. We will subtract the lower number from the upper number. Yes, so how many numbers are in the upper digit? 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And how much we have to subtract? 5. So what we will do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means this will be 0 and this 1 will be copied down. How much is left? 10 left. 10 is left. Okay. Now let's take some example that how to arrange the numbers under the columns of ones and tens and how to subtract numbers. Okay, so let's take some example. If I gave you a number 12 minus 4 is equal to dash. So what we will do? We will subtract 4 from 12. How we will do? Let's first arrange the numbers under the column of ones and tens. 12 minus 4. Now, what we will do? We will subtract 4 from 12. Yes, smaller digit is subtracted from the bigger digit. Yes, so there are 12 numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Yes, and how much we have to subtract? 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let's count how much is left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Means 12 minus 4 is equal to 8. Okay, now let's take one more example. So what we will do? First we will arrange the numbers. Now here are only ones digit. Yes, so we will write 8 minus 4 is equal to, what we will do? We will draw 8 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How much we have to subtract? 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. How much is left? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is left. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you all. Now students, look at the exercise given on page number 52. Exercise 3D. Open it. Opened. Okay, let's see the first one. First one is already done for you. One has been done for you. Yes. Now let's come to second one. 15 brinjals minus 5 brinjals equals to dash brinjals. So what we have to do? You can see here 15 brinjals. Yes. Can you see 15 brinjals here? Yes. Now 15 brinjals minus 5 brinjals means we have to cut out 5 brinjals out of these. Let's cut 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Cut it. Now how much are left? 10 are left. Yes. How much are left? Count. 10 brinjals are left. Okay. Like this you have to do rest of the 2. Now let's come to second part. Subtract. Okay. Let's subtract. Let's have a look. First one. Okay, now let's subtract. First we will subtract the ones column. Okay, ones we will subtract first. 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. So we will write 0. Now 2 minus 1. Now 2 minus 1, 1, 2. Minus 1, how much is left? 1. Yes, means 10 are left. Means 20 minus 10 is equal to 10. Let's have one more example. 19 minus 5 is equal to. Now what we will do? Let's subtract 1's column first. Yes. So 9 minus 5. How we will subtract 9 minus 5? Let's draw 9 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How much we have to subtract? 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much is left? 1, 2, 3, 4. Means 4. Now, is there any number here? No. So, we will copy this one down. Answer will be 14. Okay? I hope this much is clear to you all. In the same way, you will do the second part of this exercise. Okay? Now, let's come to third question. Okay. Third one. Amit had 18 bills. He gave 3 bills to his sister. Amit had dash bills left. So what we will do? There are 18 bills. Yes. How many he gave to her sister? 3. Now we will subtract. We can cut it also. Yes, there are 18 bills given over here. How much you will cut? 3. Yes, 1, 2, 3. You can count it and write the answer here. Now, let's do this one. 18 minus 3. Let's see how we will subtract 18 minus 6. So, first look at the ones column. 8 minus 3. Let's draw 8 line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How much we have to subtract? 3. 1, 2, 3. How much is left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is left. Now let's come to tens column. Is there any number here? No. So we will copy this one here. How many bills are left? 15 bills are left with Amit. Okay. Now fourth one you will do yourself. Now let's come to next part. That is number line. Yesterday I have told you what is a number line. I hope you all remembered. What is a number line? A line that shows some number is known as number line. Okay, now let's learn. If I gave you a number 12 minus 8 is equal to dash. So what we will do? First we will go to the first number. Yes, 12 that is. From 0 to we will move to number 12. Okay, got it. Now, how much we have to subtract? 8 means we have to come 8 step back. Okay, let's come 8 step back from 12. 1 step, 2 step, 3 step, 4 step, 5, 6, 7, 8. What we got as an answer? 4. So 12 minus 8 is equal to 4. Okay, let's have one more example. 15 minus 5 is equal to dash. So what we will do? First we will go to 15. Let's go to 15 from 0 to 15. Now how many steps we have to come back? 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What we got as answer? 10. So our answer is 10. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you all. Now look at the exercise number 3E that is given on page number 54. Here also you have to subtract. You can do this yourself. Okay, now let's come to self practice 3F. Okay, here are some problem sums. Now we will learn about addition and subtraction problem sums. Let's do first one. Read the question very carefully, because then only you will be able to know you have to do addition or you have to do subtraction. Okay, so read it. First one, Prakash invited 6 girls and 10 boys to his birthday party. How many children did he invite to the party in all? Now students, remember, whenever question is asking for all together, total, it means you have to do addition. Okay, and if the question is asking left or remained, okay, it means you have to do subtraction. Got it? This is very important. If the problem sum is having a word all together or total, it means we have to do addition. And if the word problem sum is having left or remained, asking how much is left, how much is remained, then we have to do subtraction. Okay, now let's read question number 1. What question 1 is saying? Prakash invited 6 girls. How many girls Prakash invited? 6 girls. And 10 boys to his birthday party. 10 boys. Okay. How many children did he invite to the party in all? Yes. So what I have told you right now, when we have a word all in a problem sum, then what we have to do? Addition. Yes. So what we will do? Addition. Tens, ones. Let's add 6 plus 0 is equal to 6, and 1 will be copied here. Means how many children Prakash has invited? 16 children he has invited to his birthday party. Okay, now let's come to question number 2. Yes, there were 12 bananas in a bunch. Okay, how many bananas? 12 bananas. Now, Arun and his friend ate 8 of them. Okay, how many bananas his friend has ate? 8. Okay, so we will write 8. Then, how many bananas are left in the bunch? So, what I have told you, if the problem sum is having a word left, then what we have to do? Subtraction. Yes, so what you will do? Subtraction. Okay, so question is, how many bananas are left in the bunch? So let's subtract 12 minus 8. Now children, what we will do? We will subtract 12 minus 8. minus 8. Let's draw it line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How much we have to subtract from this? 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now let's count how much is left. 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 bananas are left in the bunch. Okay, I hope this question is clear to you all. Now question number 3, I will read it but you will solve yourself. Okay, there are 15 flower pots in Baljeet's garden. In the morning, he watered 9 of them. How many plants are left to be watered? So what you have to do, you will decide by your own. Okay, now let's come to next page number. Page number 56, chapter test. Okay, first one, solve the following. Addition and subtraction. This you know how to do, you will do yourself. Question number 2. Fill in the blanks. 6 plus 6 plus 0 is equal to. Let's see this one. First one, 6 plus 6 plus 0 is equal to dash. So we will add 6 plus 6. How we will add? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then it is 0. So how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. What is the answer? 12. Okay. Second one. 8 plus 7 minus 5 is. Okay. This one is little tricky. Okay. Let's see. B part. 8 plus. See. Now here spelling is written over here. We have to write sign. Okay. 8 plus 7 minus 5 is. So what we will do? First we will add these two digits. 8 plus 7. Add 8 plus 7. What will be the answer? 8 plus 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So the answer is 15. Okay, now 15 minus 5. Now we can subtract 15 minus 5. Yes, so let's subtract 15 minus 5. Let's draw 15 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. We have to subtract 5. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much is left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What is the answer? 10. Okay, I hope this is clear to you all. Okay, now let's come to next one. C. Question number C. P plus dash is equal to 16. Now see, whenever question comes like this, it means we have, when there's plus sign, it means we will subtract 3 from this number. Whenever question comes like this and there's a plus sign, it means we will subtract this number from the answer, from the sum. Okay, then we will get this number. Okay, let's see how we will do. We will write 16 and then we will subtract minus 3. Let's do 6 minus 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's cut 3. 1, 2, 3. How much is left? 3. And we will copy this. 13 means answer is 13. Now you can check. 3 plus 13 is equal to 16. Okay, let's come to next question. D part. 20 minus dash is equal to 19. Now see here. 20 minus dash is equal to 19. Now you have to fill this part, this missing part. Now here is the subtraction sign. So what we will do? We will subtract 20 minus 19. Then we will get the answer. How? 20 minus 19. Then this will be equal to 20 minus 19. Let's subtract 20 minus 19. The answer will be 1. Yes. So the answer will be 1. 20 minus 1 is equal to 19. If there is addition, then also you will do subtraction. And if there is minus sign, then also you will do subtraction. You will subtract the question which is given on the question from the answer. Okay, I hope this much is clear to you all. Now let's come to next question. Question number 3. Monica has 12 notebooks. Her father gave her 5 more notebooks. More. Yes. So, how many notebooks does she have? How many notebooks she has now? What we will do? The word, here is the word more. More means zyada. Yes. So, what we will do? We will do addition. So, you will do this. Next one, question number 4. Summer has 17 candies. He gave 5 candies to his friend. He gave. Give means dena. Yes. He gave 5 candies to his friend. How many candies does he have now? Okay. So, what you will do? Give. Give means subtract. Yes. So, we will do subtraction. Fifth one. Show the number that equals 5 plus 4 plus 7 on the abacus shown below. Okay. Now see this one. Question number 5. The question is saying there is an abacus, tens, ones. Okay. So what we have to do? Show the number that equals 5 plus 4 plus 7 is equal to this. Now, whatever the sum will come, you will show that number on the abacus. Okay, let's see what will be the total. So, what we will do? First, you will add these two numbers. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Now, you will add this and this number. So, 9 plus 7 is equal to 16. So, the answer will be 16. Now, see which number is at ones column. See 6. So we will draw 6 beats here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now let's come to tens column. How many digits are there in tens column? 1. So we will draw 1 beats. Okay, got it? Now let's come to next question, multiple choice. Which of the following is the same as 12? Now you have to find out which is same as 12. What you will do? You will add all three options. Whatever the answer will be, you will do that. Take that. Okay. Now 7. Which of the following is or are the same as 18? Okay. Now you have to do. Now you have to find the question of 18. The sum is given over here. 18. And you have to find the correct question. So what you will do, you will subtract or add whatever the question is given over here. You will do all these three options. Whatever the answer will come, that will be the answer. Which one? Whatever matches, that will be the answer. Okay. And see, none means not any option from the given one. Means jitna bhi diye option, usme se ek bhi nahi. That is none. Okay. Now, worksheet is given over here. What you will do? Now see. First one, what you will do, first one, 11-4 is equal to 15. So, what you will do number? Yes, you have to find plus or minus. So, you can do that. You can see, if we add 11 plus 4, then the answer will be 15. It means there will be plus sign. Second one, 16-6 is equal to 10. Now, what you have to do? Now, see, if the number is greater here, it means you have to put plus sign. And if the number is smaller there, smaller than the question, yes, then you have to do subtraction. You will put subtraction sign. Okay, keep this thing in your mind. Whenever the answer is greater than the question's digit, then the sign will be plus, and whenever the answer will be smaller than the question's digit, then we will put minus sign. Okay, clear? Now mental maths. Let's come to mental maths. First one, 10 plus 8 is equal to this. You can do yourself. Second one, 13 minus 0. See, spelling is given over here. Don't be confused. This also you can do yourself. Third one, 8 plus 5 plus 4 is equal to dash. You know how to do. First we will add this, then we will add the sum of this and this number. Yes. Fourth one, which is smaller, 18 minus 4 or 10 plus 5. You will subtract the whatever the sum will come. Then you will compare the answer to the 10 plus 5 answer. Okay. Fifth one, 1 10, 6 ones plus dash ones is equal to 18 ones. Yes, it means 1 10 6 ones means this means 16 ones. Yes, yes. So 16 ones plus dash ones is equal to 18 ones. So what we have to do, we can subtract this. 18 minus 16 is equal to 2. So the answer will be 2 ones. Okay, I hope this much is understood to you all. Now challenge, what number comes just before 8 ones plus 9 ones? 8 ones plus 9 ones means you will add 8 plus 9. Whatever the answer will come, you have to write the number before that number. Okay. Now, next one, find the missing number. Okay. Let's see this one. First one has been done for you. Let's see second one. 13, 4. Okay. Now you have to fill this one. What you have to do? Now this is the answer and this is the question. Now tell me what we have to do. This is the answer and this is the question. We will subtract it and then we will find this number. So 13 minus 4 is equal to 13 minus 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 13. We will subtract 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. How much is left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So the answer will be 9. Now, if you will subtract this, then also answer will be this. If you will add 9 plus 4, then the answer will be 13. And if you will subtract 13 minus 9, the answer will be 4. Okay? I hope this much is understood to you all. Now, students, we have completed revision of chapter 1, 2 and 3, that is our assessment 1. It means we have completed revision of assessment 1. I hope all the chapters are clear to you all. You have completed your book work. You have done your class work too. Yes. So, but students, please don't stop practicing sums related to the given chapter. Keep learning, keep practicing. Then only you will gain good marks in the assessment. Okay, tomorrow I will take revision of chapter 1. Please be prepared, solve all the questions related to chapter 1, and then tomorrow I will discuss some questions with you from chapter 1. Okay, so keep learning and keep practicing. Thank you.